Welcome to the first class of Riemann integration. Today we'll be learning the how this idea was conceived at a very early stage in ancient times. We will keep the formalities and the theoretical portion of this topic for some later classes. We use the technique of integration to find the area of a curve or under a curve. The emergence of integration as the anti-differentiation is relatively a very new concept. The intrinsic idea behind Riemann integration had been in practice since the ancient time of Archimedes. Of course, this got its name due to Riemann in the second half of the 19th century only. But Archimedes used the same concept to find the area of a circle. He divided the entire circle into regular polygons with increasing sides in the following way, just like this. As the number of sides increased, the area of the polygon approached to that of the circle. Now you can see the brown area here is the area approximated by the polygons, and the blue area was that of the circle. And as you see, as the number of sides of the polygon increases, it almost covers the entire area of the circle. It covers more and more area of the circle. So if we quickly go through the idea, the mathematics behind this, so let n be the number of sides of the polygon. Then let Sn be the length of each side of the n-gon. So this is your Sn, let's say, each side of the polygon. This is a regular n-gon, so Sn is same for every side of this polygon. And let Hn be the height of each of the triangle in the said n-gon. So suppose this one, this is your height, so this is your, say, Hn. So this is the Hn be the height of each of the triangle in the said n-gon formed by joining the center to its vertices. Then the total area of the n-gon is n times area of a small triangle. So area of these triangles. So there are n many congruent triangles thus formed. If you join all the vertices to the center of the circle, then you get n many congruent triangles. So all of them are same in area. So if you know the area of one triangle, then it will give you the area of the entire polygon. So that is the area of n times area of a small triangle. That is, we know the area of a triangle, that is half into base into height. So base is my Sn, that is the length of each side of the polygon, and Hn stands for height, polygon with n sides. So then it becomes half times n times Sn times Hn. Very good. Now, as n increases indefinitely, we started with n equal to 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and so this way, as n increases indefinitely, what can we say is, nsn, the n times sn, that is the perimeter of the polygon that approaches to the circumference of the circle. So the perimeter, you see, this approaches to the circumference of the entire circle. And hn, the height, actually approaches to the, to become the radius of the circle. Okay, something I want to mention over here, that I am not writing n tending to infinity. I'm not using that notation, though I'm using the same sense over here, because to emphasize the fact that the concept of limit and the calculus is relatively very new to this concept of approximating the area of a circle by polygons. So the formal concept of, let me put it this way, the formal concept of limit and calculus is relatively new. So that is why I'm just taking the sense that n is increasing indefinitely, and then nsn is approaching to the circumference, to become the circumference of the circle, and hn approaches to become the radius of the circle, instead of using the limit, the notation of limit or things like that. So for sufficiently large n, what will we have? The area of a circle, because the area of the total polygon will tend to area of a total area of the circle, that will be half into nsn will tend to circumference, and hn will tend to radius. So area of the circle will be half into circumference into radius, and that is the formula for area of a circle. So this one is done by the Archimedes. Now Archimedes did not actually do with this processes. He did some other process. Let us not go into that, but just for sake of some motivation. So this is the process. This is the process is backed up by our common sense, and this seems to be true. So area of a circle is half of circumference times the radius. Now, at this point, we must agree to something, that the basic building block for area is a rectangle. We accept the fact that the area of a rectangle with length A and breadth B has area A times B. The proof of this fact will invoke some sophisticated set of postulates, which we intend not to do in this course. So we accept that the area of a rectangle with length A and breadth B is AB, A times B, and we keep that as our building blocks. Now, when we accept this, the following two theorems from plane geometry, that is by Euclid, will help us to find the area of a triangle, because we used triangle, area of a triangle, as the half into base times height in this setup. So let us find out the area of a triangle, assuming we know that area of a rectangle is the product of its length and its breadth. So theorem, first theorem is parallelograms on the same base and same parallels are equal in area. This is first theorem. The second theorem says, if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and the same parallels, then the area of the triangle is half of the area of the parallelogram. These two theorems together gives us this thing. So suppose we have this starting parallelogram. So this one, the area of this parallelogram will be equal to this rectangle, because by the theorem one, because this rectangle has same base and the same is lying between the same parallels as these two, the rectangle and this parallelogram. Now, if we have this triangle with the same base as with the green, the first parallelogram, with the same base and within the same parallels, then the area of this triangle will be half of this green parallelogram. And since the green parallelogram, area of the green parallelogram is same as the area of the rectangle, so the area of the triangle will be half of the area of the rectangle. Now, if we have h as the height of the triangle and b as the base of the triangle, then by our axiom that the area of a rectangle is the length times its breadth, so b is the breadth of the rectangle and h may be the height, so then b times h will be the area of the rectangle, and therefore by this theorem the area of the triangle will be half base times height. So here area of the triangle is half times area of the rectangle, that is half times base times height.